Harper's side went 1-for-3 in game one of this doubleheader. Fordham in their white uniforms, maroon trim, LaSalle in navy blue with white pants. First pitch is swung on and missed from Haggerty. Haggerty digs in. Dobman gets a sign she likes. Goes from the windup. Lined. Foul. Third base side. Quickly 0-2 to Haggerty. Haggerty came into the afternoon hitting 250. Hits a ground ball sharply, but it's foul. First base side to the right of the bag. Count stays 0-2. Scoreless here, top of the first. Michelle Haggerty, the first batter. The second game of two between Fordham and LaSalle. Dobman from the windup delivers. High, count 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. Hit in the air, left field. Coming in and diving is Turgeon, but it gets by her to the wall. Heading to second is Haggerty. Finally fielded and throw in by the center fielder, Sydney Canessa. But Haggerty gets herself a stand-up double to start game two of this doubleheader. Turgeon came running in, dove, but couldn't make the play and left.
Sort of like the first game, the way it started with Haggerty with a leadoff single, getting on base, and early in the game, if you're Turgeon, I'm not sure you die for that ball.
Refis drops down a bunt, but it's foul, fielded foul as it came just to the left of the batter's box. Angelina Refis, the left-handed hitting center fielder for this one. Michelle Haggerty on second, nobody out, scoreless between LaSalle and Fordham in the top of the first.
Refis 1-for-13 this season, appearing in her ninth game, it's her sixth start.
Pops up the bunt, third base side. Caught by the third baseman, Lindsay Mayer. Runner has to stay at second. Disappointing there from Refis as she popped that bunt up towards the third baseman, Mayer, who made the easy play.
Not at all what you want to be doing after a leadoff double, getting shut out 8-0 in the first contest. You want to be able to execute that sacrifice bunt successfully.
First pitch hits softly towards short. Brady and fields and throws to first. One pitch. Taylor Rohrbaugh goes down on a soft ground ball to short. Two outs here. The runner Haggerty advancing to third on the soft hit ground ball. Suzanne Swanicki stepping up now, the right-handed hitting catcher for the Explorers. Two outs here, runner on third. Dobman in the circle, winds up. And it's a ball away, count 1-0. The pitch, swung on and missed. Swanicki swung over that. Count moves to 1-1. Haggerty on third for LaSalle, looking to score here with two outs. Swanicki looks at a pitch that bounces to the back spot. Haggerty heading home, and she's going to dive in. So LaSalle get the first run of the afternoon in game two on a wild pitch from Dobman. Looked like a pitch low. It looked like it hit home plate and took a weird bounce to the backstop. Nothing really the catcher, Kayla Lombardo, could do. LaSalle take a 1-0 lead here at Bahoshi Field.
And this is what you worry about after a dominating 8-0 win, maybe a little bit of a slow start in the second game.
Tapped foul behind the plate.
Especially with LaSalle expected to pitch their ace in this game at some point. It looks like Mackenzie Peace will actually get the start on the hill, but expect to see later in the game LaSalle bring in Mary-Kate Scott.
After the foul ball, the 2-2. Just inside, count runs full, 3-2. It's chilly here in the Bronx in the mid-30s. Well, in the high 30s, but it feels like it's in the mid-30s. Blue sky, though, sunny weather. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed for the final out of the top of the first. Swanicki swings over that one, but not before LaSalle get a run on a wild pitch. It's LaSalle 1, it's Fordham nothing. We're headed to the bottom of the first inning here in the Bronx. Baby, you a song, you make me want to roll my windows down and cruise.
Said, fire it up, let's go get this thing started.
Mackenzie Peace on the mound for LaSalle, getting the start in game two. It's LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing here in the bottom of the first inning. Sydney Canessa leading off for the Fordham Rams, went 2-for-4 in game one between Fordham and LaSalle. Had an RBI, scored a run. Hits from the right side. Looks at a strike. Count 0-1. Peace from the windup. Ball low, count 1-1, going right to left across the outfield. Tori Galli in right, Angelina Rifas in center, Valerie Pinheiro in left. Go to the infield after this pitch. The 1-1, outside, count 2-1. Erica Reese at first, Mackenzie Obert playing second, Michelle Haggerty at short, Alyssa Bitsimis playing third, Susan Swanicki, the catcher, and Mackenzie Peace on the mound, or in the circle, the 2-1. And there for a strike on the outer part of the plate, count 2-2, nobody out here in the bottom of the first, LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing. LaSalle getting a run in the top of the first. Michelle Haggerty scored on a wild pitch. The 2-2. In there for a called strike 3. Canessa's retired. So one out. Amy Van Hoven steps up to the dish. Left-handed hitting second baseman for the Fordham Rams. Went 2-for-3 in game one. 1-for-3 in game one with 2 RBIs, a run scored. First pitch of the at-bat. Low for a ball. Van Hoven, one of those batters who moves forward as the pitch is thrown, kind of a slap hitter.
Her specialty, the slapper for Van Hoven, the sophomore.
The 1-0, shows bunt, pulls it back. Pitch is in there for a strike, count 1-1. The infield in a couple steps for the speedy Van Hoven. The 1-1. Swung on, hitting the air foul, third base side, goes out of play. Count moves to 1-2. Van Hoven digs in. Peace in the windup. Ball low, count 2-2. Van Hoven hits the bat against the cleats. Just 1 foot outside the batter's box. Now she digs in. Peace ready in the circle. Delivers. Swung on, grounded to short, fielded by Haggerty on the second hop. Throws over to first for the second out of the bottom of the first.
Nice play by the shortstop. Haggerty there. Hard hit ball right at her. Doesn't shy away. Her reaction stays true and able to make the easy play when she's able to come up with the ball off the grounder.
Lindsay Mayer digging in now for Fordham. The third baseman hits from the right side. Two outs here. Nobody on for the Rams. Peace's pitch. It's low. Count 1-0. Mayer 1-for-2 in game one of the doubleheader. Also walked and scored a run. The 1-0. Hit hard, third base side, but it's just foul. The line drive just to the left of the third base line. Fordham head coach Bridget Orchard trying to push it fair, signaling for a fair ball, but third base umpire right on it. Calling a foul, count 1-1. LaSalle with a 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the first inning on a sunny but chilly day in the Bronx. The 1-1. In there for a strike, count 1-2. Peace winds up. Foul ball hit in the air, first base side. Count stays 1-2. Peace ready, the 1-2. That's high, count 2-2. Good battle here between Mayer and Peace. Mayer with 2 home runs on the season, also 21 RBIs. It's tied for the team lead with Kayla Lombardo, who's waiting in the on-deck circle. The 2-2, check swing, slow roller, hit foul first base side. Count stays 2-2. Two outs here, nobody on for Fordham. LaSalle with a 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the first.
Mackenzie Peace really has struggled this year, Chris, to a 6.7 ERA. This is her 8th appearance. She's pitched 20 2/3 innings, and she's given up 20 earned runs, so a run per inning for her thus far in her freshman campaign.
Delivers. Called strike 3. Peace not giving up a run this inning. 3 up, 3 down for Fordham in the bottom of the third. We head to the top of the second. It's the Explorers 1, Rams nothing here at Bahoshi Field. Valerie Pinero leading things off for LaSalle in the top of the second inning. The Explorers with a 1-0 lead over the Rams. Michelle Dobman in the circle for Fordham, the right-handed hurler. Pinero, the right-handed hitter for this LaSalle side, playing left in game two with his doubleheader. Looks at a ball away. Fordham took game one of the doubleheader with an 8-0 victory. Seven of those runs coming in the fifth inning. A Kale Lombardo grand slam really helping the Fordham cause. The 1-0. Hit in the air, right center field. Ioneer going back. It's going to bounce and hit against the wall. And that's going to be a double for Pinero. As a sharp line drive hit to right center field makes its way to the wall. And LaSalle in business here in the top of the second inning.
Yeah, Michelle Dobman getting hit pretty hard here. That's now two leadoff doubles in this game and two solidly struck softballs to get both Haggerty in the first and now Pinero here in the second inning to second.
Mackenzie Obert up now for LaSalle, right-handed hitting second baseman. First pitch of the at-bat, bunt shown, bunted right in front of the plate, fielded by Lombardo, the catcher, who throws to first, but the sacrifice bunt is completed. As the runner advancing to third.
Interesting there. It almost looked like that ball hit the bat twice, Chris, as it came and landed just in front of the plate with some weird spin on it, but the umpire says no, it was a clean bunt, and that allows the runner Pinero to get over to third.
Erica Reese digs in. Looks at a pitch inside, 1-0. Reese playing first for the Explorers. Good opportunity here with Pinero on third and one out for her to get an RBI. The 1-0 bounces up there. Good block from Lombardo.
Yeah, Dobman having a rough start to this season thus far. Last year, she finished 18-11 with a 2.73 ERA, and this season at 4.65 in the ERA. That's her highest over her four-year career.
The 2-0 high, count now 3-0. Here comes the 3-0. Ooh, swinging green light, but swung through a pitch high. Count moves to 3-1 as Reese had the green light there.
Up 1-0. Runner on third trying to get that sack fly or base hit to make it 2-0.
Delivery. It's bunted, a squeeze. The ball comes home, and the runner's tagged out. Now going to second is going to be Reese. And she's going to slide in safely. But the lead runner tagged out his home as the bunt went back to Dobman, who threw to Lombardo to get Pinero at the plate.
And if your
Reese ran to second and nearly slid in front as Lombardo fired it down to second with the shortstop Brady in covering. Big break for Fordham. The runner from third doesn't score. Two outs now. Runner on second for the Explorers.
It's just dumb. To be blatantly honest, it's dumb coaching.
But Simmis looks at a strike. Elizabeth Simmis, the third baseman, hits from the left side.
Yeah, I just don't understand. You're ahead 3-1, and now then you decide to do a safety squeeze.
Ball low, count 1-1.
Of course, it could have been executed a lot better by Erica Reese, but up 1-0 already. I understand you lost the first game 8-0 and trying to get a 2-run lead, but the safety squeeze on a 3-1 count, I just don't understand.
Count 2-1 after a ball away. Reese on second. Bit Simmis in the box. Two outs here. Slow roller hit towards third, fielded by Mayer. Throws to first for the final out of the second. Dobman gets out of a jam. LaSalle with a runner on third and one out. But a failed suicide squeeze, and LaSalle don't get a run across. It's LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing. We're headed to the bottom of the second.
Yeah. that's where the party's at. This is how we roll.
Kayla Lombardo leading things off for Fordham in the bottom of the second. LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing. Here in the Bronx, Mackenzie Peace in the circle for the Explorers through a scoreless bottom of the first inning. First pitch of the bottom half of the inning. It's a ball high, count 1-0. Fordham went down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the first inning. Couple strikeouts for Peace in that half inning. The 1-0. It's a ball away. Count 2-0. Kay Lombardo 1-for-2 in the first game of the doubleheader, but that won a grand slam that turned a 2-0 Fordham advantage into a 6-0 Fordham lead. The 2-0. Sharp ground ball fielded by Bittesimis. She fires on to first for the out. Lombardo hit it right on the screws, and it was just found its way into Bittesimis' glove. She got Lombardo out in plenty of time for the first out of the bottom of the second.
Just an incredible natural reaction from Bittesimis over at third base. Saw the ball coming at her, and her natural reaction was with the left hand. The glove just scooped forward, and the ball ended up in her glove. And like you said, Lombardo robbed of a definite single.
Dobman digs in. Looks at a ball low. Count 1-0. Peace toes the rubber. Goes from the windup and delivers. Popped up. Second base side in a shallow right. Obert gets under at the second baseman and makes the play. Just a couple feet behind the dirt where the dirt infield ends. On the turf in right field. So quickly two outs here in the bottom of the second. Cora Ianiro. Right-handed hitting right fielder for Fordham. Digs in against Peace. Nobody on for Fordham. Two away here in the bottom of the second. LaSalle with a 1-0 lead. Ianiro looks at a ball away. Count 1-0.
Rams trying to get their first base runner of this game.
The 1-0. Ball low. Count 2-0.
Ianiro last year was an all-A-10 championship player and an all-regional player, and when Fordham played at the NCAA Tallahassee Regional.
The delivery. Hit in the air, right field side, but it's slicing into foul territory. Ianiro got jammed there. Had a soft line drive. Foul, count 2-1.
Ianiro also some success against LaSalle last year. She scored 3 runs in a doubleheader sweep of LaSalle Beck on April 26th, almost a full year ago, or 11 months ago.
2-1. It's a ball high, count 3-1. Good hitter's count here for Ianiro. Ianiro coming into the doubleheader today, hitting 205, 16 hits, 78 at-bats. The 3-1, grounded softly towards third, fielded by the shortstop Haggerty, who just gets Ianiro in time at first. Once again, 3-up, 3-down for Fordham. In the bottom of the second, it's LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing.
We'll be right back. shimmer on hot lips, silver buckle hanging off her hips. I sparkle when she smiles, shine down on the radio dial. Homemade jar of lemon drop, take a sip, don't stop, girl, you know.
Top of the third inning. Fordham and LaSalle here from Bahoshi Field. And to lead off for the Explorers with Dobbin on the hill, the number nine hitter, Tori Golly. First pitch missed outside, 1-0 now the count. Kayla Lombardo immediately out to go talk with Michelle Dobbin. Maybe just a quick sign correction. The count 1-0 to the nine hitter and right fielder Golly. Her first at bat of the day. Fouls that pitch straight over us. Count even at one. Dobbin now ready here. Here's the 1-1. Just missed outside. Looks like she wanted that one. Golly, a 143 hitter coming in. Swings the 2-1 right back to Dobbin, and she makes the catch. Just a little nubber off the end of the bat. One away here in the top of the third.
So you want to start things off with your Dobbin. Good power pitching there. Get the first out here. Has to be frustrated giving up that run back in the top of the first. But since then, seems to have started to settle down.
Michelle Haggerty, the shortstop, gets her second at bat here in this one. Doubled back in the first. Takes strike one on the outside corner. Also a couple nice defensive plays in this second game of two already. Haggerty was a 250 hitter entering today's action as she takes the 0-1 away. Count 1-1. Dahlman ready with the 1-1, delivers, fouled right back into the netting. Three hits for LaSalle the first time through the lineup, but a couple of hard hit foul balls, a couple of pitches they're just missing. They seem to be on Dahlman a little bit more than they were on Gillen back in game one where they fell 8-0 to the Rams. Here's the 1-2 from Dahlman, missed outside, 2-2. Haggerty, the only run in this one, back in the first. Swinging at the 2-2 pitch, grounds to short in the hole. Brady and Fields fires the first across her body and gets her. Nice play by Allie Brady and showing off the arm strength from deep in the hole.
Really was. You said it, backhanded that in between short and third. Threw it off the back leg and put a good throw to the first baseman.
Angelina Refis, the lefty, to the plate now for LaSalle. The slapper takes the first one for a called strike. Popped to third. And to Lindsey Mayer back in the first inning. Didn't start in the first game, but she's starting in this second one. The 0-1 pitch takes outside. Ball one. LaSalle going with a pretty much a substantially different lineup in this game after falling 8-0. Sal still trying to figure out their season. A lot of games canceled as the 1-1 pitch is offered at by the slapper. Almost looked like a bunt attempt.
Yeah, I thought it might have been an attempt at a drag bunt from the lefty.
It counts now 1-2, the pitch. Taking ball two just outside. Lombardo. And some of the Fordham players might have taken a couple of steps towards the dugout on that one. The fans thought it might have been a strike as well. The 2-2 now. Fouled the way down towards the third baseline. And it'll continue to roll towards the outfield in foul territory. And Lindsey Mayer tracks it down and throws it in. Nobody on for Reifus here. Two outs in the top of the third inning. LaSalle up 1-0 after losing the first game of this doubleheader 8-0. The 2-2 fouled away into the netting. Reifus continuing to fight up there for the Explorers. Looking to make their bus ride home after this one a little more pleasant, having split the doubleheader. The 2-2 pitch inside, and it gets a piece of Reifus. She's going to head down to first base after being hit by the pitch. And, Chris, that's got to be a scary sight, the slap hitter moving forward, the slapper. And as she gets closer to the pitcher and towards the front of the batter's box, the ball's coming right at you, and you have no chance of getting out of the way of that one.
Well, she appears to be fine. The scary part about it is more that less time to turn your back. And the way she was kind of running forward, she didn't have a chance to turn her back. So your whole body's exposed when the pitch is coming in. Looked like it caught her maybe on the hip or on the thigh.
And what just happened there was head coach Bridget Orchard asked for an appeal to the second base umpire to see if that was a foul ball. First pitch taken for a called strike by Rohrbaugh.
Or to see if she swung.
The 0-1 pitch, hit in the air, foul, and it's going to just get into the seats, and a nice catch by a member of the LaSalle cheering section. And he sits down and checks his phone. I'm not sure why, but
he has to act like he's done it before. Natural reaction. You got to act like it was a routine play, sits down.
He's actually going to take a picture now, maybe of the ball in his hand. I don't know. But perhaps he was just got a text message while he was catching that ball. The 0-2, right back to the pitcher. Dahlman Fields fires to first, plenty of time. And Taylor Rohrbaugh goes down. LaSalle gets nothing in the top of the third. No hits, no errors, and one left after 2.5. It's LaSalle 1 and Fordham nothing. Bottom of the third inning, game number two between LaSalle and Fordham. Fordham a winner 8-0 in game number one. They trail LaSalle 1-0 in this one, though. Rachel Gillen leads off the bottom of the third. Designated player in this one. Got the win in the circle in the first one. She fouls the first pitch away.
Yeah, great outing in the first game. Six innings, only about four hits, no runs, and 11 strikeouts.
Absolutely dominant on the hill for the Fordham Rams. Also had two hits in that first game at the plate. We'll try and help her team out here now. Behind 0-1, the pitch down low, 1-1.
Selling her short, 3-for-3.
3-for-3.
Snuck a third hit in there.
It's the 1-1 pitch to Gillen. Swung on, hit towards second. Obert to her left. Fields underhand flipped to first in time. And Gillen retired. The Fordham baseball team has just lost their game in Richmond, 15-5, and gotten swept by the Spiders, and they'll head home and try and get things in order before their next A-10 weekend series coming up on Thursday here in the Bronx. Paige Ortiz to the plate on the right side. Takes ball one outside. Before Gillen headed to the bench after grounding out, a few words for Ortiz, maybe some sort of scouting report. Is this the first at-bat Ortiz has had against the pitcher piece? Ahead 1-0, the pitch. Outside 2-0. Good pitch for the eight hitter coming most likely. Ahead 2-0. Nobody on, one out, bottom of the third. Ortiz ready, piece delivers. Takes again now 3-0. Ortiz 0-for-3 in the first game. Ahead 3-0, down 1-0. Ortiz with some power, probably the green light here. The pitch taken for ball four. And she'll reach first. The first base runner for the Fordham Rams in this one. And Brianna Turgeon now steps to the plate for Fordham.
Fordham with their first base runner after that walk. Good opportunity here for Turgeon to start getting something going for the Rams.
Turgeon with four home runs, tied for the team lead with Michelle Daubin. Ortiz off first. First pitch coming to Turgeon. Swung on, a big swing. She missed it, though. That was a home run swing.
It's funny, LaSalle bringing the corner infielders in. And funny because Turgeon is taking a huge whack right there. LaSalle may be anticipating a sacrifice bunt attempt.
No, one pitch to Turgeon, taken for a ball. Ortiz on first. Doesn't necessarily run incredibly well, but the sacrifice bunt could still be successful. But Turgeon, having seen two pitches and looking to swing at them, unlikely to show a bunt now. The count 1-1. Here's the pitch. Inside for a ball, 2-1. Brief mound visit now coming out to chat with the pitcher Peace and the catcher Swinicki. It looks like assistant coach Mary Pat Conville, who graduated from LaSalle in 2010 and was a four-year standout there. Actually, it looks like Taryn Ashway, the 2013 A-10 Pitcher of the Year at St. Joe's and now coaching at LaSalle. Would make more sense considering talking with the pitcher Peace. Count 2-1 to the hitter Turgeon with one out, Rams down 1-0. Here comes the pitch from Peace. Taken for a called strike two, about the outer part of the plate. Count even at two to Turgeon, the left fielder. Peace in the circle, on the rubber, ready. Ortiz ready on first. Pitch, swung on and missed, strike three. Turgeon goes down swinging, and there's two away.
Yeah, Turgeon didn't shorten up there with two strikes, still took a home run swing. Just couldn't get the bat all in the ball. Gets retired.
Sydney Canessa now the batter for Fordham. The center fielder struck out looking back in the first, trying to make something happen with two outs. Pitch from Peace. Popped in the air, swung on by Canessa, right back to Peace, and she doesn't even have to leave the circle. And she makes the easy play. Rams, no runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base through three. LaSalle's up 1-0 over the Fordham Rams.
I'm gonna wear my flip-flops and I'm gonna play some flip-cupping, rock a little bit of hip-hop and haggard.
Top of the fourth, Suzanne Swanicki to the plate to lead off for LaSalle. First pitch to her, swung on and missed. Count 0-1. The 0-1 missed outside. Now 1-1 the count. Dobman starting to get into a little bit of a groove after giving up a run in the first inning. Here's the 1-1 inside, and she hit the batter. Swanicki gets hit. That's the second batter Dobman has hit in the now last two innings, consecutive innings. Two out of three batters have been hit by a pitch.
They're leaving her mark on these LaSalle players.
Oh, I see what you did there.
I thought it was clever. It was a pretty bad joke, though.
I thought it was well done.
I appreciate the
consideration.
I'll give
you credit for that one. First pitch to the hitter, Pinheiro, is swung on and missed. The left fielder at the plate now. Played a little bit of third base in the first game. Came in as... Actually, she started third base in the first game. Doubled back in the second inning of this game. She takes the 0-1 high before being thrown out at the plate on a safety squeeze. Got all back in the second inning. Now the count 1-1. Shows bunt, but bunts it foul. Touched by Lombardo in the left-handed batter's box. As Pinheiro standing in the right-handed batter's box.
Bunting's been a bit of an issue for this LaSalle team this afternoon. In the first game and in this one. Popping out a bunt, the safety squeeze that didn't go as planned.
Pinheiro from the right side, behind 1-2. Pitch missed high. Dobman looks like she might have slipped off the rubber there a little bit. So Swanicki, the catcher, off over on first as the 2-2 missed outside to Pinheiro.
Heart of the order here for LaSalle.
3-2 count. Don't want to put Pinheiro on here. Two on, nobody out. The 3-2 from Dobman. Swung on towards second, fielded by Brady, and flips to second. One over to first. Not in time. Bang, bang play at first. Right call was made. One away now for the Fordham Rams defense here in the top of the fourth.
Brady and field that ball in the hole. Thought maybe that was a situation where she would have taken another step and tried to step on the bag herself. She elected to flip it to the second baseman. Still a close play at first.
Mackenzie Obert, the second baseman, stands in now. Her second at bat of the contest. Called strike one on the inside corner. Obert, a successful sacrifice bunt back in the second inning. Behind 0-1. Pitch. Called strike again. This one on the outside part of the plate. So Obert takes one in and now takes one away. Here's the 0-2 now, fouled away. Straight back towards the backstop here at Bohoshi Field. Top of the fourth inning. LaSalle leading Fordham 1-0 here in game number two. Pitch from Dobman, 0-2, again fouled away. Ron Shoemaker, a little trouble picking up the ball.
Yeah, I tried to make the play. The LaSalle third base coach and head coach. And couldn't field it cleanly. Kind of a little bit of a grin from him.
And E10 over there. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and missed. Mackenzie Obert goes down. Two away.
Just a pitch high out of the zone at about eye level. Obert a little overly aggressive right there. Swung right through it.
Erica Reese now steps to the plate, her second plate appearance of the day. Fielder's choice in the second inning. She reached on and she takes strike one on the outside part of the plate. And that fielder's choice was the safety squeeze. And she was able to get all the way down to second base. The 0-1 pitch swung on and missed on the off-speed pitch. A nice one from Dobman. Counts now 0-2. Dobman Dobman ahead 0-2. Here's the pitch. Down low, 1-2. Lombardo came up quick. Thought about maybe throwing behind the runner Pinheiro over at first. Dobman gets the signs a second time. Now she's ready. Here's the 1-2. Swung on and grounded towards third. And Ron Shoemaker, that's two E10s in one inning.
Yeah, that's a bad one. It was coming straight for him, and he kind of picked the hand up on an Olay right there from Shoemaker. And if I was a LaSalle player, I'd definitely tell him, you got to get in front of those. Get the body down, get in front of those.
Looks like he's having a little laugh with the Fordham dugout. The 1-2 fouled straight back at us. Coming right for my eyes. Luckily, we have netting and a window in front of us.
Very lucky.
Incredibly lucky.
Well, you used to play catcher.
I should have been able to get the hands up. Here's the 1-2. Missed outside. 2-2.
Kayla Lombardo, the Fordham catcher, trying to frame that one. Kind of pulled it back a little bit. Didn't get the call, though.
2-2 the count with two outs. Pitch from Dobman. Called. Strike three. Got her. That'll do it for the fourth inning for the Explorers. No runs, no hits, no errors. One left through three and a half innings, that is. Halfway through in this softball contest. LaSalle 1 and Fordham nothing. Bottom of the fourth inning here at Bahoshi Field. The LaSalle Explorers up on the Fordham Rams 1-0. Mackenzie Peace has been solid on the hill thus far. Through three innings, she actually has not given up a hit. She's walked one, and Amy Van Hoven stands in. Pitch swung on and fouled away out of play over the Fordham dugout. Van Hoven grounded to short back in the first inning. The slapper for the Rams stands from the left side, or usually the slapper. Steal one pitch to her. Takes it for ball outside, 1-1.
Fordham still looking for their first hit here in the bottom of the fourth. Got their first base runner in the bottom of the third.
Yeah, just a lone walk to Paige Ortiz in the last inning at the plate for the Rams. The 1-1 showing bunt Van Hoven, but pulling it back and taking it for a ball. 2-1. Van Hoven can get on to start this inning. 3-4-5 comes up. Lindsay Mayer, Kayla Lombardo, and Michelle Dobman, presumably. 2-1 pitch. Swung on. Grounded in between the hole between first and second. And a base hit for Amy Van Hoven. And the first hit of the game for the Fordham Rams here in the bottom of the fourth.
Good piece of hitting there from Van Hoven. Just put a good part of the aluminum on it. Hit a sharp ground ball between first and second. And the speedy Van Hoven is on. 7 of 9 stolen base attempts this year. And of course, the heart of the order coming up for Fordham.
I haven't seen any runners yet here at Bahoshi Field this entire season. This is the third game at Bahoshi Field. Mayer the batter now. First pitch swinging over towards third, just foul. Amy Van Hoven got a pretty good break over there. Might have been a hit and run. Count now 0-1. Mayer, the UVA transfer and sophomore here at Fordham now. The 0-1 pitch, missed away. 1-1 now the count. Lindsey Mayer trying to help engineer a couple of runs in this inning for the Rams. Here's the 1-1 to her. Called strike two. Mayer can't believe it. Sort of hung her head a little bit. Looks back at the umpire. Bridget Orchard can't believe it. Takes her headband off. Looked like it was low and away. Now Mayer will step back in here. Have to know that anything close here will likely be a strike following that reaction. The 1-2. Missed outside. Way too far outside. Count even at two. Kayla Lombardo on deck. Long grand slam in the first game. Lindsey Mayer ready for the 2-2. Takes it for ball 3-2. Van Hoven, an aggressive start after the ball released from Peace's hand.
And Peace really staying away against Mayer. Strikes away, missed the last two pitches on the outside, or just off the outside part of the plate.
Here's a 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed by Mayer. Mackenzie Peace got her. Kayla Lombardo now steps to the plate for Fordham. 0-1 today, but again, that grand slam in the first game. Probably about 2 hours ago now. Timeout as a
dodgeball makes its
dodgeball,
way on.
Dodgeball, kickball, a red.
I believe it was kicked, but a dodgeball.
Yeah, Murphy Field right behind the right field fence. Looks like some intramural soccer is starting to take place after a club lacrosse game just ended as Kayla Lombardo takes strike one. Looks like Fairfield and Fordham just played a girls lacrosse club game. Lombardo behind 0-1 now. Van Hoven on first. Pitch. Van Hoven going for second. Slides in time, and she's able to hold the bag. A stolen base for Amy Van Hoven. It's going to be her eighth of the season, and the Rams now with the runner in scoring position for the first time in this one.
Swanicki with a good throw down to second. Van Hoven somehow slid past the tag.
Just beat the throw. 1-1 pitch to Lombardo, fouled straight back, 1-2. Speedy Van Hoven on second. Single from Lombardo to anywhere but left field. Looks like we'll get a run in. Left fielder Pinheiro, the most shallow, and then Reifus and Golly deep in center and right. The pitch to Lombardo hit in the air towards right, over to her left. Golly heading towards the bullpen. Can't get it. It falls foul. Even if that was caught, Van Hoven likely would have been able to tag and get to third easily. But I'm sure Lombardo is happy to see another pitch. Try and bring her in with a base hit. She's behind 1-2 with one out. Here at the bottom of the fourth. Pitch coming from Peace. Swung on, hit towards second. Fielded by Obert. Fires to first in plenty of time. Van Hoven does get to third. So although Lombardo out, I guess you can say semi-productive out. But still two outs. But does open the door for a wild pitch. Scoring the runner from third.
Gives Dobman a chance to help out her own cause here.
That as well. A definite base hit. Or a base hit will definitely bring in the run now. Dobman ready with it. Swings the first pitch right back to Peace. Fields it. Fires the first in time. Mackenzie Peace works out of trouble for really the first time in this game too this afternoon. No runs for the Rams. One hit. No errors. One left. Through four. LaSalle one. And Fordham nothing.
plant your roots in it. Dusty headlight, dance with your boots in it. You write her name on it, spin your tires on it, build your cornfield whiskey bonfires on it. You bet your life on it. Some crosses and some painted gold posts through it.
Alyssa Bitsimis leading off the top of the fifth for LaSalle. The Explorers with a 1-0 lead here at Bahoshi Field. Chris Venezia, Drew Casey, my partner in crime, for this doubleheader this afternoon. Taris Lejetsky on the controls. First pitch of the fifth, low and away.
Chris, what crime did I commit?
I don't have a comeback for that. You really caught me off guard there, Drew. I don't know what subconnection. Maybe you stole a napkin. Subconnection, the eatery near Fordham. The 1-0. Grounded towards short. Brady and fields the medium speed roller and throws on to first for the first out of the top of the fifth. Wasn't a slow roller. Wasn't a hard hit ball. It's a medium well ground ball.
A medium well ground ball. Okay.
Went away here in the top of the fifth. Tori Galli heading from the right side. Looks at a ball away. Popped out to the pitcher back in the third. Dobman, the righty from the windup. Delivers high, count 2-0. Dobman gave up a run on the first. Michelle Haggerty scored on a wild pitch from third. It's the only run of this game so far. The 2-0 swung on and missed from Bitsimis. Count 2-1. One out here, top of the fifth. Nobody on for the Explorers. LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing.
These are outs you want to get if you're Fordham, especially Dobman. The 9-hitter Galli up now before you get to the top of the lineup.
An off-speed pitch. And Bitsimis way out in front. Count 2-2. Excuse me, Galli up for the Explorers. 2-2 low and away.
Yeah, definitely not a player that you want to walk if you're Dobman. You want to keep your team in a 1-0 deficit. Give them a chance to tie it up coming down the stretch.
The 3-2 line towards second, and actually one hops to Van Hoven. He throws on to first for the second out of the top of the fifth. Two quick outs here for Dobman. The shortstop, Michelle Haggerty, heading from the right side. Up now for LaSalle. 1-2 with a double. And this one went 1-3 with a double in the first game of this doubleheader. So 2-5 in the afternoon. Looks at a pitch away, count 1-0.
And she's probably been the best offensive player for LaSalle in this one. And outside of the second baseman, Obert, probably the best defensive player as well at shortstop for the Explorers today.
The 1-0. Lined in between short and third. It's actually a slow line drive that hits the ground before the dirt, but it squeaks out to left field. A base hit for Haggerty. As Turgeon brings the ball back in the infield.
Didn't get a lot of that one, but nonetheless, it's a single. But it's a two-out single, so you get the first two hitters of this inning, the 8 and 9 hitter Bitsimis and Galli respectively, and then you give a hit to the best player, Haggerty, today, and you've got yourself still in a fine situation.
Reefus up now with two outs. The pitch. Runner going. The throw to second is in time. And Haggerty gets thrown out trying to steal. So LaSalle get one runner on, but she's promptly thrown it at second base. No runs, one hit, no errors. Nobody left on base for the Explorers. It's LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing. We're headed to the bottom of the fifth. Nero leading things off for Fordham in the bottom of the fifth. Nero 0 for 1 this afternoon. Well, in game 2, this afternoon she's 0 for 4, going back to the first game of this doubleheader. First pitch at the bottom of the fifth. It's a line drive off the netting foul, first base side. Town 0 and 1. Mackenzie Peace throwing a gem for the Explorers, only giving up one hit in four-plus innings of work. In the windup, delivers. Pitch inside for a ball, count 1-1. Aya Nero coming into this doubleheader, hitting 205. Couple home runs. The 1-1. Lined up the middle, and it's going to drop in the right center field gap, fielded by Refus in right center field, who gets it into second. But Aya Nero with a base hit. Now 1-for-5 between the two games. And Fordham in business to start at the bottom of the fifth. Rachel Gillen, the left-handed hitter, stepping up now for Fordham.
And the way the day has gone today, you might not ask for a better situation. Gillen, 3 hits in the first game. She did ground out to second back in the third, but the leadoff hitter, Aya Nero, on now with Gillen at the plate.
First pitch of the at-bat. Fouled the netting third base side. Count 0-1. Aya Nero getting Fordham's second hit of this game. LaSalle with a 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the fifth. Aya Nero on first. Gillen at the plate. Ball bounces up there. Count now 1-1.
Nice play by Swanicki there to keep it in front of her and keep Aya Nero at first base with no outs.
Aya Nero 1-for-2. Stolen base attempts this year. The 1-1 to Gillen. Hit in the air, softly towards center field, and is going to drop in shallow center. But the second baseman, Obert, is going to get Aya Nero out at second. So it ends up being a 4-6 fielder's choice. So on paper, it looks, you know, like a reasonable 4-6 fielder's choice. But in reality, Gillen getting jammed, the ball landing just behind the dirt, behind the bag at second base. The second baseman and shortstop, neither one of them calling for, but with the awareness to pick it up and get the force out at second for the first out of the bottom of the fifth. Gillen on first. Now Paige Ortiz, right-handed hitting first baseman at the plate. Looks at a ball low, count 1-0.
Hey, Chris, the sun really giving these players difficulties throughout the day. We saw the right fielder back in the first game for LaSalle. Travers have trouble with a fly ball. Then we saw Van Hoven and Brady with trouble second in between second and short, and then just there, same with LaSalle.
The 1-0 hits sharply towards second, throw to short, now the throw to first, pulls the first baseman Reese off the bag. So just the out at second base as Obert, the second baseman, fielded it on a hop, threw it to Haggerty at short, but Haggerty couldn't complete the double play. Two outs and Ortiz on first for Fordham. Now Brianna Turgeon steps up to the plate. Turgeon struck out in her last at-bat. Hits a ball in the air, shallow center field. Reifus coming in, is going to get there and make the play. Just to the right of the block F in center. So Fordham get a base runner, but strand that base runner. We're headed to the top of the sixth. It's LaSalle 1, Fordham nothing here at Bahoshi Field.
I got my shades on top, back rolling with the music jack. One on the wheel, one around you, baby.
A little sun left to burn in the blue sky, shining off the cross hanging from the mirror of my ride. Breeze blowing in, your hair blowing round. You scanning through the stations looking for that country sound. The good stuff, I stuff in the back seat. Nowhere to go, nowhere to be. I got my shades on top, back rolling with the music jack. One on the wheel, one around you, baby. Sunset, I bet there's a chance we could get shore enough, tangled up, lay back and lazy. Pour it on easy now, don't spill a bit. Nothing but time tonight, let's get to killing it. Long as I'm rocking with you, girl, you know I'm cool with just chilling it. Nothing but two-lane country on up ahead. Girl, you so fine, I wouldn't mind if this is all we did. You got me
home. Top half of the sixth inning, the second game of a doubleheader here at Bahoshi Field on a chilly Sunday afternoon in the Bronx. It's gotten warmer throughout the day, a sunny day. Leading off the top of the sixth, Angelina Reifus swings at the first pitch and soft liner over into the third base stands.
Look like a check swing or three-quarter swing there from Reifus. Kind of an excuse me swing, and she fouls it off.
The 0-1 pitch. Reifus takes outside 1-1. Popped to third in the first and hit by a pitch back in the third. The only run in this game came from the first player to step to the plate all the way back in the top of the first. Michelle Haggerty, a leadoff double. The 1-1 pitch taken inside by Reifus. Haggerty advanced to third on a ground ball and then scored on a wild pitch with two outs, and that's the only run on the board thus far, and we're in the top of the sixth. They play seven here in softball. The 2-1 hit on the ground past the diving Bradian and into left field for a single.
Sure, LaSalle would love to have some insurance. Just up a run here in the top of the sixth inning.
Roarball showing bunt, gets it down. Ortiz fields, fires the first, and gets to Van Hoven, the second baseman covering first. So successful sacrifice from the three hitter to get Reifus over to second.
Yeah, beautiful bunt there, just deadened it. A couple feet in front of the plate, moving the runner over. Giving LaSalle a good opportunity here. Runner in scoring position and one out.
Suzanne Swanicki, the catcher and cleanup hitter. 0-for-1 in this game. To the plate, first pitch from Dobman, taken for a called strike on the inside corner. Dobman back on the rubber, ready now. The 0-1 pitch. Hit in the air towards left, headed towards the foul line, but it just goes left of the foul line and it'll slowly roll to the fence. If you're listening or watching this game, make sure you also put Michigan State and Louisville on. Final 30 seconds, Michigan State up by one. Count 0-2 to the batter, Swanicki. Hit right back to the pitcher, Dobman. Fields looks back the runner and throws to first. So best case scenario there, if a ball is put in play, you hold the runner at second, and you still get the out for if you're the Fordham Rams. So now two away and a runner on second.
Yeah, good work there from Dobman. Look the runner back, hold the runner at second base, almost nullifies the sacrifice bunt.
Valerie Pinheiro, the left fielder, to the plate. First pitch swinging slowly to the second baseman, Van Hoven. Picks it up, fires to first in time. Side retired. No runs, one hit, no errors. And one runner left on base through 5.5 innings. LaSalle, the only run on the board. They lead Fordham 1-0.
When my world is on my right, I got my shades on top, back rolling with the music jack. One on the wheel, one around you, baby. Sunset, I bet there's a chance we could get short enough, tangled up, lay back and lazy. Pour it on easy now, don't spill a bit. Nothing but time tonight, let's get to killing it. Long as I'm rocking with you, girl, you know I'm cool with it. Just chillin' it. Nothing like a little you and me, low-key. Right now I'm right where I wanna be. I got my shades on top, back rolling with the music jack. One on the wheel, one around you, baby. Your sunset, I bet there's a chance we could get short enough, tangled up, laid back and lazy. Pour it on easy now, don't spill a bit. Nothing but time tonight, let's get to killing it. Long as I'm rocking with you, girl, you know I'm cool with just chilling it. Yeah, I love rocking with you, and girl, we're just chilling it.
Defensive change for the LaSalle Explorers. Now in left field, replacing Valerie Pinheiro, is Kendra Heyer. She played left field for majority of the first game today, so she'll go back to her left field position. Mackenzie Peace in the circle, and Sydney Canessa, the leadoff hitter, up for the Rams to start the bottom of the sixth. First pitch missed outside, 1-0. Canessa ahead, 1-0. Here's the pitch. Swung on, grounded towards third for a base hit. Past the third baseman, Bitsimis. A missile of a single for Sydney Canessa to start the sixth.
And you got to think, third time through the lineup for Fordham facing the pitcher Mackenzie Peace. She's had herself a terrific outing so far. Only giving up three hits, counting the one right there. But maybe this third time through the order, Fordham can start getting some answers.
Amy Van Hoven, the second baseman now up for the Rams, standing from the left side. With Canessa on first now. Shows bunt, takes it back, and takes for a ball. Count 1-0.
Have to imagine here with the 3-4-5 hitters coming up for Fordham. Good opportunity to lay down the sacrifice bunt.
One would think so, and Van Hoven can really move too out of the box, so you could turn it into an infield hit. Shows bunt again, puts it down in front of the plate, hustling towards first, fielding, and an infield single, a bunt single for Amy Van Hoven. First and second, nobody out for the Rams.
Yeah, and she knew it too. The second she put that down, put the head down, and easily beat that out. Sal does have somebody warming up in the bullpen, so we'll see if that comes into play.
It's like Ron Shoemaker speaking with the...
Looks like Mary-Kate Scott warming up right now in the bullpen. And now coming in from the bullpen, it appears.
That's one of the most bizarre pitching changes I've ever seen, as head coach Ron Shoemaker reached for the ball and then Mackenzie Peace tried to give it to him. Then they both kind of like looked at each other, and then the ball was given. An interesting change, but a change nonetheless. Mary-Kate Scott on to pitch. In a bit of a jam here as the Rams have first and second and nobody out.
Yeah, you're thinking, what a time to hand somebody the ball.
Mary-Kate Scott coming into this contest. A 3.11 ERA. She's 2-2. She started three games. This will be her ninth appearance. 25 and a third inning. She's given up 23 hits, 14 runs, but only four of those 14 runs have been earned. 13 walks she's given up. The junior out of Quakertown, Pennsylvania. So she will get some warm-up pitches. And the Rams will try and get back into this one here. Trail 1-0. As, in case you're an NCAA basketball fan, a March Madness fan, Michigan State currently leading Louisville 65-64 with 3.2 seconds left. Louisville has two shots from the line, down one. Foul was just called that game in Syracuse. But we've got an exciting one here, too. Lindsay Mayer now to the plate. First and second, nobody out for the Fordham Rams. Mary Kate Scott getting set in the circle. Lindsay Mayer set at the plate. The first pitch to her. Missed upstairs with what looked like an off-speed pitch, but that is the first pitch we've seen from Scott. First pitch, or the next pitch down low for a called strike, 1-1. Counts now 1-1. Scott does not seem to have brought the heater yet. The 1-1 pitch, taken outside, 2-1 as LaSalle showing some defensive formation changes as Mayer at the plate, first and second. No out, the 2-1 pitch, swung on, hit by Mayer, deep to left center field, headed towards the scoreboard, off the scoreboard, it's out of here. Lindsay Mayer, a three-run homer, and the Rams, just like that, they lead 3-1 over LaSalle.
And that was a no-doubter. The second she hit it, everybody here knew that ball was gone. Caught the scoreboard just for good measure. And boy, the tables have turned here. Last game was Kayla Lombardo with the grand slam. And the player right in front of her, Lindsay Mayer, turning the tables here and giving Fordham a 3-1 lead.
Kayla Lombardo now to the plate. First pitch from Scott to her is misses inside, ball one. And Lindsay Mayer took that pitch, looked like an off-speed pitch, just hung there, and right off the scoreboard for a home run. 1-0 to Lombardo, missed down low, 2-0.
And it was the fifth inning in game one of this doubleheader where Fordham was able to get seven runs. And now in the sixth inning, Fordham starting to tack some runs on.
2-0 pitch missed. It's now 3-0. As now Michigan State and Louisville are headed to overtime for your basketball fans. Stay with that one. Stay with us here as we've got a close one down to the wire. Fordham up 3-1. The 3-0 to Lombardo called strike. Count now 3-1, score the same in favor of the Rams. Lombardo takes ball four outside. As Mary Kate Scott, after giving up that home run, just looks discouraged. And she's been warming up a lot, Chris, throughout this game, and it just doesn't seem like the velocity's there.
Maybe that's just the type of pitcher that she is. I think the big thing is she warmed up a lot last game, warmed up a lot this game.
Daubman first pitch swinging foul down the left field line.
But she finally gets in the game. Maybe all those warm-ups got her out of her groove. I think it's more of just a sense of you give up a home run to the first batter you face. Your team loses the lead. I think it's kind of tough. That's a discouraging thing. Tough to come back from. Really test your character.
Have to keep her team at this deficit because they've only got three more outs to play with as Daubman swings at that pitch, pops it up over towards third, hits the glove of the third baseman charging in Bitsimis, and she touched it in fair territory and safe at second is Kayla Lombardo. What are we calling
And that's an infield single, it looks like. But really unfortunate. I mean, it was a great pitch, jammed the hitter. Just the third baseman making a diving effort, just couldn't get to it in time. Maybe, and I know this is in hindsight, but maybe it would have bounced and moved foul.
Ioniro shows bunt, pops it up, but it falls down now, throwing to first. Scott just in time to get Ioniro. Lombardo gets to third. Daubman gets to second, and going back to the previous batter, Daubman agreed with you, Chris. That ball might have even gone foul from the get-go and likely would have rolled foul, but that's a big time in the past moment as now Rachel Gillen to the plate. One out, runners on second and third. The Rams a chance to extend their now 3-1 lead. First pitch to her, missed outside, 1-0 on the off-speed pitch.
And it's just one of those things when things aren't going your way. Things like that, just numbers, when players get jammed, kind of find their...
1-0 to Gillen, hit in the air towards right center, coming on, but falling in front of her. A base hit for Gillen, coming home to score easily is Kayla Lombardo. Michelle Daubman had to hold up as didn't get a great read on the ball, but an RBI single for Rachel Gillen.
Even right now, right there, not the hardest hit ball in the world, but just finds a spot in the outfield for a base hit. Things really just going Fordham's way here in the bottom of the sixth.
Head coach Bridget Orchard coming over to home plate umpire Joe Alphonse. Going to make a substitution, a pinch runner coming on to run for Rachel Gillen is Kaylin Winokur. We saw Winokur come on to run in the first game as well. Paige Ortiz will remain the batter. First and third for the Rams. One out, four runs in the bottom of the sixth inning for Fordham. Ortiz at the plate where she's 0 for 1. First pitch swing. She mashes it into left center field. It's going to get down. And for a long, long single, Paige Ortiz, an RBI single. And the Rams now up 5 to 1.
Yeah, and the hits just keep rolling. It's very similar to the first game of this doubleheader, when Fordham got 7 runs in the fifth inning. The hits just kept coming, some timely home runs. And you don't go back that far when it was a 1-0 LaSalle lead and Fordham only had 2 hits. They now have 8 hits in the ballgame.
Yeah, and nothing against Mary-Kate Scott on the hill, or excuse me, in the circle for LaSalle, but just doesn't look like the velocity is there and something is not right. Either that, or if she is this type of pitcher, she's clearly missing her spots. And you wonder if head coach Von Shoemaker for LaSalle, you know, maybe suspected this, and that's why she doesn't get in the game until now, but bring her in with up 1-0. And just like that, you're now down 5-1. Some mirror images to the first game with a big inning late in the game for the Rams.
And you have to think it's a tough situation, too, with the fact that this is your relief pitcher. You went to the pen for this reliever.
Morgan Figueroa will now pinch run at first base. So Figueroa running at first, Winokur running at second. Rams up 5-1. Rihanna Turgeon to the plate. Swings the first pitch and gets it past the first baseman. Rounding third and headed for home. Winokur going to get there easily. No play at the plate. An RBI single for Brianna Turgeon. And the runs keep on coming for the Fordham Rams.
A little inside out there from Brianna Turgeon. But hit a hard line drive just past the first baseman. A good play from the right fielder, Tori Gali, to keep that from going to the fence. And even more damage from happening, but now runners on the corners, one out in the top of the order, back up for Fordham.
Top of the lineup, still one out. Runners on the corners, Canessa, the 10th hitter of this inning. First pitch takes it for a strike on the outside part of the plate. Rams clicking on all cylinders at the plate this inning. Their third time through the lineup, and now Canessa starting the fourth time through the lineup. The 0-1 pitch taken outside, 1-1. Chris, we said this in the first game. We never thought we'd have a mercy Janelle now in that position again, up 5 runs and continuing to get more runs. Canessa swings at the 1-1, fouls it back. It looked like Turgeon was in motion.
Really eager Canessa on that pitch. It looked like she was leaning forward, maybe a little bit out in front. Gets a piece of it and fouls it back.
The 1-2 to Canessa, swings on it over towards the LaSalle dugout, heading over the first baseman, and she can't make the catch as Erica Reese could have corralled it. And the ball did hit a very good piece of her glove just over near the fence. She's maybe a little scared by that fence. 1-2 pitch to Canessa, swings at it over towards right, coming on Golly. She'll make the basket catch, tagging from third and heading for home. Play at the plate, none. Run scored, sack fly. Morgan Figueroa touches, and it's now 7-1 Fordham.
And that's why you bring on the pinch runner for that situation right there. Figueroa showing off the speed. I thought it was going to be a close play at the plate, and she scored standing up.
The Rams now up 7-1. Amy Vanhoven to the plate now for Fordham. Second time this inning. She singled and scored earlier in the inning. Slapper takes ball one. So Turgeon on first base. Amy Vanhoven can actually end this game with a home run here. The 1-0 pitch takes for a strike. 1-1. Looked like it was a little high, but 7 runs in this inning. Strike zone might have widened a little bit. Vanhoven ready. Here's the pitch. Swung on, grounded towards second, and right through the legs of the second baseman, Obert, rounding second, heading for third. Is Turgeon. She gets there. She'll head home even now, and she's going to get there easily. And reaching second is Amy Vanhoven. The wheels falling off for LaSalle here in the bottom of the sixth. 8 runs in for the Rams in this inning alone.
Yeah, it's a sharp ground ball, but when your pitcher is struggling the way she has, Mackenzie Obert, who, to her credit, has played terrific defensively, you got to help your pitcher out right there and make a play. Stay down on that ground ball. And just a really tough inning for the Explorers.
Error all the way. No RBI. Lindsay Mayer, a chance to end the game here. She takes strike one. Rams up 8-1. 8-run mercy rule could take effect if the runner on second, Vanhoven, can score. There's 2 outs here. Mayer behind 0-1. Here's the pitch. Missed outside, 1-1. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Mayer. It's down low, 2-1. Sydney Canessa ended the first game with an RBI double to bring in Brianna Turgeon to get the 8-run mercy rule and the 8-0 win. The 2-1 to Mayer swung at the off-speed pitch and missed it. 2-2.
I'm trying to remember, but I feel like it was Mayer's Vanhoven who had the last hit in the first game that led to the mercy rule.
The 2-2 pitch, swung on, hit in the air towards right. Golly coming on, battling the sun. She'll make the catch. So we will have a 7th inning here. That'll do it for the bottom half of the 6th inning. But for the Rams, 8 runs on 7 hits, 1 error, and 1 left on base. Through 6, Fordham now up 8-1 over the LaSalle Explorers.
Got every guy in here spinning around, spilling their beer. I bet you came out to have a good time. So what you say we leave your friends with mine? Yeah, they'll be alright. I just wanna see you shine. Girl, you're tearing that dance floor up. Let me see you do it in the bed of my truck. You sure know how to shake it all right. Let me see you do it in the Tennessee. Whoa, baby.
think about taking that chance, taking a ride, taking my hand, kicking this crowd, ditching this club. This night's been waiting on us. Save your best move. Yeah, till I get us where we're getting to. Girl, you're tearing that dance floor up. Let me see you do it in the bed of my truck. You sure know how to shake it all right. Let me see you do it in the Tennessee moonlight. Whoa, baby, let's go down a little road.
Mackenzie Obert leading off the top of the seventh here for the Explorers. Fordham with an 8-1 lead. Dobman still on the mound for the Rams. First pitch is fouled straight back into the net. Obert 0 for 1, has a sacrifice bunt back in the second, struck out in the fourth. This game changed in a big way in the bottom half of the sixth. It was a 1-0 LaSalle lead, Fordham getting 8 runs in the bottom of the sixth. Ball high, count 1-1. Dobman looking for a complete game here. 1-1 low, count 2-1. Dobman toes the rubber. Gets a sign she likes. Hit in the air. Right around home plate. And it's caught by Dobman about 5 feet in front of home plate. Just a high pop-up. Right up the elevator shaft for the first out of the top of the seventh. Erica Reese stepping up now for the Explorers. Hitting from the right side. She's 0 for 2. Reached on a fielder's choice in the second, struck out in the fourth. Swung on and missed, count 0-1. The 0-1, it's low, count 1-1. Dobman from the windup. Pitch inside. Count 2-1. A lot of Fordham fans disagreeing with that call, thinking it's a strike. The 2-1. In there for a strike. Count 2-2. Reese digs in, the 2-2. Swung on and missed. Dobman gets the strikeout. And we have two outs here in the top of the seventh inning. The Explorers down to their last out. Also down 7 runs, 8-1 here in the top of the seventh inning. Dobman one out away from a complete game performance. The pitch outside for a ball, count 1-0. The 1-0 in there for a strike. Nice pitch there from Dahlman on the outer part of the plate. The delivery. Low, count 2-1. Alyssa Bitsimis, the third baseman, hits from the left side. She's 0-2. On the afternoon, but Simmons digs in, looks at a ball, 3-1. Here comes the 3-1, fouled straight back, count now full.
Pam's looking to sweep the doubleheader here.
The windup, the pitch, and it's low, ball 4. LaSalle get a base runner on. Tori Gawley steps up now, the right fielder. Hits from the right side. Dobman, the right-handed hurler on the rubber, winds up. It's a pitch away, count 1-0. Dobman looks in, gets a sign she likes, delivers, swung on and missed. Count 1-1. Pitsimis on first for the Explorers. The 1-1. Just outside, count 2-1.
Not sure where that one missed, Chris.
Just a little bit outside. Fordham 8, LaSalle 1 here in the top of the 7th. LaSalle down to the last out of the ball game. It's fouled off into the netting first base side. Count now 2-2. Swung on and missed. Staubman gets strikeout number 5 to end this one. It's Fordham 8. It's LaSalle 1. Fordham sweep the doubleheader against the Explorers to improve to 3-2 in A-10 play. Stay tuned. The one-on-one post-game report is coming up right now. Welcome into the one-on-one post-game report. I'm Chris Finezia, Drew Casey alongside me and Terrace Lejetsky on the ones and twos. And Drew, a good afternoon for Fordham. Get two wins, and really it was two innings that led to Fordham's two wins.
It was. It really was. You look back to the first game, they win 8-0, and they get eight runs in one inning it was, I believe, or was the case. If I'm
eight
not
in
mistaken.
Eight runs in this second game of the doubleheader, seven runs in game one of the doubleheader. They got seven,
that's right, seven
in, the
runs
fifth,
in the fifth
and one in the sixth.
So eight runs in the bottom of this sixth inning of this game, number two, and, you know, partially LaSalle's wheels fall off, a couple of hits that maybe shouldn't necessarily be hits because of the sun playing.